Good morning. So today we're on the wonderful Lake Kaniere in New Zealand. And here we have it, this beautiful view of the mountains surrounding me. So today, on this beautiful summer's morning in Lake Kaniere, I'm going to talk to you about long exposure photography on mountain lakes and what we're looking for in terms of that exposure. So today I've got my camera set up, and the first thing you can see here, I'll come around here, is here. I've got my polarizing filter on, just to take the glare to exactly the right level that I want on my camera. So this thing is absolutely fantastic for taking out the glare that you don't want, and really concentrating on the colours that you do want. Now, the only problem is there's quite a lot of blue sky, so you have to be quite careful with the polarizing filter. So I might take it off in time to come. I've got my foundation kit here, and I'm going to start off with that polarizing filter and start taking photographs with that. So, first thing, the benefit of long exposure photography. So there are two ways of approaching it. So the first way of approaching it is without filters. So what we do here is, if I just show on the back of the screen for a minute. So I've been taking photographs at f11 on ISO 64, and that already enables me to get some slow shutter speeds. So you can see here, by taking it down to f64 or f11, you're talking roughly just over half a second. So when we take that shot, kind of bracket the shot, I'm not using a timer at this stage. If we go into the shot, you can see you get a really, really nice clear picture of the lake. But the difference is you get these ripples. Now, this lake is so calm, so peaceful. I'm not sure if I want all these ripples in the foreground, or indeed anywhere on the lake. So what I need to do is something very, very different. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna bring you back around here. Right, so I'm gonna use my 10 stopper. Now, I've done videos about this before. I've done videos about long exposure photography in different places. I do use this quite a bit, but it's a fantastic way to take really, really distilled reflections. So for this one, I need to use completely different camera settings, and you'll see why in a minute. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do, take you back to the camera again, so you can see why I'm doing this. Okay, so on the back of the camera, first of all, you'll see at the moment, I've got it where I want it in terms of ISO as lowest as possible, so that's highest quality. F11, that's a great f-stop to use for getting everything nice and sharp. And then half a second. Now, if I look up half a second, I've got a bit of a problem. So, what I do with my filter is I use this app here. So if I show you this app here, sorry, it might look a bit funny on your screen. If you go to 10 stops, which is the one at the top, okay, and then we look at your current exposure is on the left, okay, and then you look at the exposure that you need for a 10 stop filter, you will see that you need 8 minutes. That is ridiculously long. In 8 minutes, you could easily nudge a tripod. You could do all kinds of dodgy things to the camera in 8 minutes. 8 minutes is ridiculous. So what we need to do is we need to compromise. So I want to be able to get it down to a minimum of maximum of a 2 minute exposure. So in order to do that, if we have a look at this app again, I need it on 1/8 of a second or thereabouts. So what I need to do now in my camera is I need to make sure that I can get down to that kind of that amount. So what I'm looking for is 1/8 of a second here. Otherwise, it's just going to be too much of a problem getting it there. So first of all, I'm going to compromise slightly on my aperture. You can compromise pretty much down to f/8 if you want to. Okay, so now it's 1/5 of a second. So it's looking better. So the next thing to do is compromise on the ISO. And now I'm on 1/100th. In fact, I'm going to take that f-stop back up. And I'm going to compromise on my ISO a little bit more. So I'm on 1/25th of a second at f/10, and now I'm at f/8. Now, I'm not going to go for 2 minutes. I'm going to compromise a little bit more. I'm going to go for 1/10th of a second at f/10. So 1/10th of a second is going to be roughly, if I look on here, roughly 1.5 minutes. So for this, I'm going to use this. So you can use, this is just a normal kind of plug-in Nikon timer, but you can pretty much use anything. You can use an electric timer, you can use whatever you like. I'm going to use this and the Big Stopper app, and the Big Stopper app counts down. So first thing I'm going to do, if I come around here on this side of the camera, okay, I am going to be putting my Big Stopper in here. So first thing I need to do is get that Big Stopper out and get it in there. So when I do this, the one thing to remember is you may have a problem focusing when you get the Big Stopper in. Sometimes the camera finds it quite hard. Think of this as a mega pair of sunglasses, and this is a pretty dark pair of sunglasses. Okay, so the sealed edge goes to the inside of the camera, and this goes on the inside edge of the camera here into the slot here. So I'll just pop that in. Generally, don't push on your lens too much as you're going down. Just pinch it like I am, okay? Right, I've got my Big Stopper in there now. So that is now with the polarizing filter as well. Now the polarizing filter adds about 2 stops as well. So in total, this is about 12 stops. Now what this is gonna do is it's gonna delay my shutter speed in daylight. And delaying the shutter speed enables me to then produce a really, really, really smooth shot. Okay, now I've got my camera set up with the Big Stopper in it. So at this point, it's ISO 160, f/10, okay? Now this is the point that I need to change, because otherwise I won't get the correct exposure. So the first thing I need is I need to make sure that I've put this into manual. So manual mode on the top here. So next thing is this. I'm now going to take this down to, going to keep these seconds going, and you will see that the exposure changes as I do this. Now I'm going to take this down all the way to a setting called bulb. Bulb is basically an unlimited exposure time. You can leave your exposure on for as long as you want, and bulb is the one that we need to use. Okay, there we go. So we can see there that 1/25th of a second, just under 1/30th there, is just over 30 seconds. So when I start this, it's going to be 40 seconds exactly. So if I start that and then make a start with the exposure. So 40 second exposure, it's not that long, but it'll still have exactly the same effect. And that's really, really important. Wow, I've got so much muzzy repellent on and I'm still getting eaten alive. This is quite a beautiful environment. Stunning, in fact. Okay, let's see how we go. Thank you. that's what I was looking for. So in this environment, you've got those beautiful reflections here. Zooming into that, that is looking really, really lovely. Now, I would love to stay at this location and talk to you about long exposure photography, but I'm getting eaten alive again. Anyway, I've just been photographing this wonderful scene here. Now, this bank here, just out here, provides this beautiful area for long exposure without having to, I'll take you around and show you. So this area here provides this beautiful still area. So if I take this down like this, you can see these beautiful reflections I've just been photographing. And you don't need a filter, you don't need anything, because the bank provides a super still area for reflections. And you get this beautiful vista with the contrast of the lake and the ripples moving in the background. Right, I'm gonna move on. I've already inhaled one bloody mosquito. So, it's gonna be an interesting one, this. The midges, the New Zealand midges, I think they're as bad as Scotland. good God. Anyway, I can't complain, it's the most beautiful view. It's just quite hard to kind of sit there peacefully, thinking about the time and space and beauty of it all when you're getting eaten alive and hailing little buggers. Anyway, so we're coming up to an area called Sunny Bight, which is a kind of, which was just an area of the lake. A lot of what I'm photographing from today is roadside and picnic areas and things like that. But it doesn't matter. What's important is the beauty of the space. And it is absolutely stunning. Like this. Look at that. That's what we're here for. So, long exposure. So basically, you only use a filter when you need to. You need to make sure that you're still maintaining the character of the landscape, and you need to make sure that you get the right exposure timing. So that's absolutely essential, so that you know when to expose and what to expose for. And yeah, you also need to do a little bit of HDR photography as well. But all in all, it creates a really, really beautiful view when you get it right. So there we have it, long exposure photography. So it was a great walk, just wandered around the track around Lake Kaniere, taking in the sights. So long exposure photography in mountain lakes and mountain areas, it's all about making sure that you come at the right time of day, early morning, late at night, making sure that the filters that you're using, that you're timing them well, and also experimenting with not just what the app says, but also like different types of timings, because you need to not only get the kind of the kind of flatness of the water right and that reflection, you also want to expose for the sky as well. So it invariably means putting together a couple of different exposures in Lightroom or Photoshop in order to get that final image. But that won't ultimately affect the way that image looks. It'll still look really, really natural talking about natural. There's a speedboat coming along. Makes it slightly less natural right now. Anyway. So the kind of beautiful, peaceful nature that was Lake Kaniere is now slightly disrupted by a bunch of speedboats. Anyway, that's inevitable. It's part of life here. So, anyway, please, if you like this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.